Hey guys, Northwest Adventure Rider here. I've been putting off this video for way too long and I just need to get it done now. I ended up ordering I think it's a Moose Racing skid plate for my bike. One of the last rides I went on, I hit a big rock and it dented my stator cover, so I figured it was about time. Been doing lots of things in real life, so I haven't had much of a chance to get this done, so I thought I would just break down and do it real quick. Give you an update on some of the things I've been doing. I had to put my dog down. He was a hell of a good dog. He was an older boxer, and he ended up with lung cancer, and it was just time to put him down. So that was pretty hard for me. But also, I've been working on the DT project a little bit, not much. I've got one of those Harbor Freight soda blasters. I'm borrowing it from my aunt and uncle, and been cleaning up the frame on it. It's slow going because my air compressor is too small, but it works pretty well. And take a look at this. So here's the frame for the DT project, and you can obviously see where I've already got the soda blasting done, and just down to the bare steel, and then the parts that I haven't done yet. Works awesome. Unfortunately, I found out the hard way that you shouldn't do soda blasting just outside your garage door with the garage door open and the wind blowing to the inside of the garage, because then your entire garage gets a coat of white dust. It's everywhere. And right now my garage is an absolute mess. So everything has a coat of baking soda now. But back to the pig. So like I said, I got the Moose Racing skid plate for it. You can see right now I've just got the factory skid plate down there. It's not really even really a skid plate. It's more of a crash bar type thing. I don't know really what purpose it serves other than protecting the oil return line. So in the box over here is the Moose Racing skid plate, and I ordered it from Happy Trails. And one of the first things I'm going to do is go ahead and weigh the plate so you guys know exactly how much it weighs. Okay, so I've got my digital scale here. I'm going to go ahead and grab the skid plate. Looks like the skid plate weighs 3 pounds. 3 pounds even. 3 pounds, 1 ounce. So it doesn't weigh very much at all. And one of the first things that I noticed about it was that it was significantly thicker than I had anticipated. All right, so here's the skid plate. And you can see it's quite a bit thicker than what you would expect it to be. It's about 1/8 inch thick or so. Okay, so first thing that we need to do to put this plate on is to remove the factory crash bar system. So in order to do that, we need a 10 millimeter. First off, there's two bolts right here on the front of the engine that you need to remove. Those are going to be a 10 millimeter. And then on this side right here, there will be a nut and a bolt, usually 10 millimeter, but in my case, it's 7/16. And then now we'll transition to the other side of the bike where we'll remove one last remaining 10 millimeter bolt. Okay, I'm going to start by saying I haven't installed one of these before and I have not read the directions, so I'm going to be kind of playing it by ear, but looks to be pretty straightforward. There's these three clamp type deals which appear as though they will clamp right onto the frame of the bike, and the nuts are welded onto the back side of them, and they use an Allen head bolt. So they slip into these three holes right here on the skid plate, so we'll go ahead and get those installed. First thing I'm going to do is install the front 10 millimeter bolts loosely, and all of the mounting holes on the skid plate are oval shaped, so they allow for any adjustments and for ease of installation. Okay, and here we have the finished product. I'm sure you've all seen this on the XR650Ls before, but sits real tight. And on the bottom here, you can see there's a drain hole for when you're changing the oil. And right in there, you can see the little clamps that grab hold of the frame. So, and it provides nice protection for the case on the side and for the stator cover. Right here is where the stator, or I had a rock hit my stator cover. So I decided it was time to get that changed. So anyway, I hope this video was somewhat helpful, and don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe.